What's going on, guys? This is Boot. I just recently finished putting together the gun that I'm going to use at Customer Appreciation Day at Wacky Warriors. I decided just to go ahead and dismantle my 2002 Intimidator here. It's got it pretty badly right now. No ram sleeve, no ram, no bolt, no frame. This gun ain't firing right now. I took the parts all off of this that I needed, and I ended up building a awesome-ass Alias Intimidator with it. So, basically, I went out and I bought a body. I went out and picked up a new bolt. Had to acquire a LPR front block and regulator. Plumbed that all up. I used a Lurker Ingen ram, used the stock poppet. What else did I do here? The board that's in here is the infamous Tadao M6 board. Cut that sucker on there, should come right on. Awesome board. I couldn't reuse the 2K2 eyes and the 2K5 body, so I ended up installing 7th Element green laser eyes, which work awesome. They help with the batteries. And it's honestly true, because when I would leave my batteries in this marker overnight, it would be dead in the morning. It seems to last a lot longer with the laser eyes in there. So either those eyes are always like functioning, they're always drawing some type of current or something, because there's nothing like you're about to go out there, you turn on the marker, and it dies. I would say anybody that has one of these, definitely get some laser eyes. Definitely. Because they last a lot longer. And you can actually see what's going on in the breech there. So if the light ain't on, that means your eyes are jacked up or pinched or something. I'm using my Autococker two-piece barrel. I thought it matched really well with the black and the chrome front. It's a 687 back, total length of 13 inches. I also have another Empire backboard, which is a 681, because y'all know the paint is getting tiny. Other than that, I think it's, I'm pretty sure this is a CP swoop trigger. I've got a pen. I took a ballpoint pen. A spring-loaded one. I cut the spring real short, and then I stretched it, and it prevents my gun from bouncing. So I really don't use the mechanical bounce settings in the board. I just rely on the spring, and that seems to work really well. Before, with no spring in it, it was just bouncing like crazy. And even though I was upping my mechanical bounce settings, it was still bouncing. So a spring definitely will fix your trigger bounce issues if you have that. I'm using the 2K2 huge pizza pie Ashcroft gauge there, which is awesome for reading pressures. I'm guessing the day of the game I'm just gonna have to take this gauge off before I break it. It's like a $40 gauge, and I'm not trying to break it, so I'll probably just go ahead and stick a plug in there, or put one of these small 300 PSI gauges on there. It'll rock up to the pressure and then it'll just stay there, so don't really need the gauge on there. I mean, it's nice to have, all you need to do is check it once before you start, and then you're good for the rest of the day. I do have the check it unimount on-off on here. Not the best on-off, but definitely works. It matches the color real nicely. It's got a CP regulator on here. This whole front block, LPR, and reg were anode. It was actually on a Empire, 2005 Empire Intimidator, and they parted it out, and I was able to pick this whole setup here for about $35, I believe. The body was $12. The ram sleeve I pulled out of my 2K2. It's been working really nice for me so far. Definitely gonna kick some ass out there when we're out there. getting about 7.5 pods with this on 4,000 PSI. I think that's mainly due because the paint is so much smaller now that you're losing shots. So that's what's up there. Got some Empire grips on here. I'm probably going to end up selling this marker after that day. I'm not sure what I'm going to sell it for. You know, maybe my boy Brett or one of my friends want to buy it off me. I have no idea. But yeah, this gun's going to it's gonna mow some bases come Customer Appreciation Day out in the woods. Big time. Another gun that I've been messing with lately is the Shocker. Old SFT Shocker. This one happens to be, it got re-anodized. I don't know who anodized it, but this is how I acquired it. Basically, dust white with that candy apple polished green, hybrid headlock on it. The trigger absolutely stinks. I hate the trigger. I cannot walk this trigger for shit. Basically, I'm ramping with this one. it still has the same board in it, which is the Cricut board. I mean, you know, it makes like whoop, a little noise on the back. I mean, it's fast and everything. It's just that I keep seeming to break paint with this thing, and that's real frustrating. Real frustrating. The maintenance is not bad on it. The eyes on this gun don't even work. It uses those crap like reflective eyes, or I don't know. It's like a ribbon. It looks like a piece of tape. If it had the Intimidator style eyes with the actual wires on it, like this one's got wires, this gun would probably work almost flawlessly. The things that I really do like about this gun, it is so quiet, man. It is so quiet. And it really just feels good in the hands, honestly. So, I wouldn't want to spend over $200 for a Shocker. I think I got this one for about, I don't know, like $140 on eBay. It was one of those steals. It came with like a dye mask and a crappy Spider TL or something like that, and two pod packs, all for $140. I guess no one was really feeling it, but I'm gonna put it to use. Let my friends use it, see what they think about it. But other than that, I think that's all I've got right now. I think it's using a 687 Freak insert on this. I do like these Freak barrels, man. They're nice. They got a lot of porting on them. They use the insert kit, so you only need one barrel, and then you can just put in any insert you want. And you can usually find the inserts online on eBay or PB Nation, Tech BB, IntimidatorDays.org. They usually go on for like $10-15 per insert, so it's not really hard to find the insert that you want. You know what I'm saying? They're out there. You can get them. The efficiency with this gun sucks. I would say with the SFT, I mean, this is using the complete stock engine in it, and I'm only getting maybe four pods or 4,000 PSI with the full loader. This Intimidator smokes it. I mean, it smokes it bad. I'm kind of worried that if I take this out for Customer Appreciation Day, where the matches are like, I don't know, almost an hour long a piece, this gun ain't gonna make it through it. And they fill your tank up to 4,000 PSI. I don't think this gun will make it. I would say that the efficiency is really close to my Invert Mini, but to me, the Invert Mini is a better gun than the Shocker SFT. I'm not sure what the big difference is between the NXT and the SFT is, besides definitely the eyes and the detents and probably the board, but I know they were still putting the Cricut boards in those NXTs for a while. My boy Joe has one. My first experience using the Shocker, I'm out there, he's like, oh man, it's running great, you know what I'm saying, yada 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 yada. He gives me the gun, I go out, first shot, poof, nothing. Second shot, takes off like a rocket, boom! I got broken balls in the breech and the barrel. That was my first experience using a Shocker, and it wasn't this one. I was like, you know, probably gonna have to get a new board for this. I think A&S Gear right now, they have the, is it, yeah, I think it is the Seventh Element board for $54, and then if you want to get real adventurous, you could try the Hater board for it. I'm not sure what's up with those Hater boards, because, man, they seem to be dirt cheap, like $40, $30, brand new. So either there's something wrong with those boards, or they're just giving away a phenomenal deal on them. Other than that, the clamp and feed neck that the guy put on here is really nice. Holds the loaders pretty good. It's just a little V35, clamp it down. So, definitely like the hybrid headlocks. This is the first headlock that I've had, and I like it. Yeah, I hate a junk feed neck, so this one'll work. Yeah, this gun will probably be really good for, you know, like speed type games, speed ball, hyper ball, but like hardcore woods ball, probably want to stick to a poppet, or I'll use a mark. I'm trying to think what else I might use out there. The FEP Quest. The FEP Quest, man, smokes this motherfucker. I've got one, and it definitely smokes the shocker. Everywhere. The trigger, the efficiency, the board, the feed neck. I mean, this is an upgraded feed neck, but the feed neck's better. The only thing that I give better is the barrel system. The barrel system on the shocker is badass. The SFT regulators, they're pretty good. They've got the adjustment through the bottom, so you don't need any crazy type of tool to adjust it. The detents on this could be better. The eyes could be better. That's about it. It's got a nice gauge to read the pressure. There's no LPR on this gun. It's just, it runs at 200, and you know, you just chrono it in from there. Other than that, though, it still is a nice gun. I still think they're worth, you know, 150, 200, unless you're getting like some like crazy mode Tauntaun or hybrid. Or I think probably the coolest shotgun that I've seen is the Russian Legion, and you know, people want $500 for those, but I mean, you're going to get the same performance as the Russian Legion as even SFT. So, I mean, if you got the money to spend on a badass shocker like that, that's cool. Me, I like to get my markers cheap. That way I can get more of them, sell them off, let friends use them, try them out, you know, see what the flavor of the week is with these. I guess, you know what, I'll go ahead and weigh these in and see. I mean, both of these have boards or batteries in them. You go ahead and weigh it. You're probably not going to be able to see this from the camera that far away, but I got 2 pounds, 12.2 ounces for the SFT shocker. Weigh in this here Intimidator and see what this is saying. It's got a board in it, or battery in it. Carbon fiber 6845. Gotta have one of those. Got the battery in there. Looks like 2 pounds, 8.2 ounces. Significantly lighter than the shocker over there by 4 ounces. So, yeah, shocker, Intimidator. If y'all see these coming at you, you in trouble. Peace. I'm good.